What's going on, guys? This here is a. It's going to be a very quick walkthrough of Droidwall. I believe it was the first IP firewall available for the Android system. It was the first firewall that I ever used back when I first got my first Android phone. And yeah, it's a very simple firewall, not that many features, so that's why it's going to be a very quick walkthrough, okay? So, here it is. Droidwall, all right. The feature available in Droidwall that pretty much became standard for all firewalls to come was the whitelist blacklist method, right? So you click here, and you have the option of either using a whitelist or a blacklist firewall. A blacklist firewall basically denies access to the internet for all the apps that you add to the list, and vice versa, the whitelist firewall grants access to the internet for all the apps that you add to the list, right? I usually use a whitelist. That way, any apps that I just installed will be automatically denied access to the internet unless I go into the firewall and grant it access, okay? So, menu. You have the option to enable and disable logs, as you can see here. You have the option to enable and disable the firewall. And if you make any changes to the firewall, like that, you can save the changes, right? Now, more. You have the option to show logs, show your rules, clear the log, because it gets kind of messy after a bit, set up a password, and set a custom script, right? That's basically it for Droidwall. Like I said, it's a very simple firewall. There's not many features, but as a firewall, it works. That's probably why it's still available on the market, even though it hasn't been updated since 2011. Now, the next firewall that I'm going to be talking about is Android Firewall, which is a fork of Droidwall, which basically means that the developers used the coding for Droidwall as a base and then built their own firewall from that, adding more features and blah 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 blah. Basically, you can consider Android Firewall as an update to Droidwall since it hasn't been updated since 2011. So stay tuned, I'll be talking about Android Firewall next. Later. I forgot to mention widgets. So for Droidwall, you only get one widget. This little thing right here, right? So one click enables the firewall, another click disables it. So when it's green like this, it's enabled. One click, red, disabled. That's it. Okay. Later.